He was an MP for 25 years. He made history in Parliament, the first openly gay MP. He fought for issues like medically assisted dying. But his political career came to a dramatic end 15 years ago after Svend Robinson admitted to stealing a diamond ring worth thousands of dollars. He was, as he openly admitted then, dealing with a mental illness issue. Now Svend Robinson wants to make a political comeback. He's the NDP candidate for the riding of Burnaby North, which is just next to Jagmeet Singh's, the riding he wants to win. But what kind of NDP does Svend Robinson want to fight for? Let's find out. He joins us here in studio. Welcome back to Ottawa.
Good to be back, Evan.
And welcome back, maybe, to the political fray. I got to ask you, because I remember in 2004, after your dramatic exit regarding the theft of the ring, you and I had a conversation,
yeah.
And I remember it very well. What are you saying to people? You're asking people for their vote and their confidence again. How are you explaining that incident 15 years later?
It's interesting. I don't have to explain that incident. One of the things that I did before I made the final decision to run was, first of all, I talked to people that in the community. I talked to people that know me, community leaders, people that were encouraging me to run, and I said, you know, is this going to make a difference? They said, look, it's 15 years ago, for starters, it's 15 years ago. You made a terrible mistake. I acknowledge I made a terrible mistake. But that's not who I am. That's not who I am. And they said, people know your record. They know the record that you have of service to the community before. They know afterwards. They know the issues around mental illness. There's a lot more awareness now, by the way, of the whole challenges around mental illness. I made a mistake. Should I have to pay for that mistake for the rest of my life? I don't think so.
Let's get to the stuff they might be talking about now.
Yep.
You were on CTV's Power Play with my pal Don Martin, and you announced to everyone that as an NDP candidate, you believe there should be no new oil and gas infrastructure.
That's correct.
So you're not just against the Trans Mountain oil pipeline. That means you would be against the liquefied natural gas pipeline in British Columbia that the NDP government there supports. You're against that as well.
What I have said, let's be very clear on what I've said, is that we've been given a warning. This is the IPCC report. Okay, that tells us that we've got 12 years to turn things around. David Suzuki spoke at my nominating meeting, Evan, and what he said is that the next election is the most important election in the country's history. I believe that, and unless we have a radical transformation away from fossil fuels in a very positive way. Let's look at green energy. Let's look at energy retrofitting. Let's look at building those houses.
Okay, but that's different. Hold on.
Yeah?
You said the word radical, so I mean, no new oil and gas. So yes or no, you would oppose that, like, natural gas pipeline.
You're against that. I oppose any new oil and gas infrastructure, including that particular one.
Not only
because we cannot begin to meet our targets, in my view, and I know others disagree. It's a Democratic Party.
Not others. You know. Your leader disagrees. Your leader, Jagmeet Singh, was on this program. I asked him, do you support that natural gas pipeline? Yes, I do. I support that one. He said it's got First Nations support of elected First Nations leaders, band office leaders. He supports that. You don't. What does it say about the party when a star candidate like you openly differs from your own leader on a fundamental issue?
You know what? What does it say about it? What it says is we're a Democratic Party. We're not a monolithic party like the Liberals and Conservatives. What it says is that Jagmeet Singh and I both agree that Justin Trudeau has been a disaster and betrayed the trust that he had on the environment. He went, remember, to Paris and Canada's back and we're going to meet our targets. What does he do? He buys a pipeline, the Kinder Morgan pipeline, which, by the way, is ground zero in my constituency. It's those tanks that are on Burnaby Mountain. It's those tankers that are in Burrard Inlet. It's the Tsleil-Waututh people, the First Nations in my constituency that are saying
so
no.
So that'll be your fight. That'll be part of it.
That'll be part of the fight.
But you're also going to have to fight within your own party.
I'm not going to have to fight in my own party at all.
But explain that to me. But it's really important. If people want to vote for the NDP, and they know, wait, Jagmeet Singh is running in Burnaby South, and he supports a natural gas pipeline. Svend Robinson is running in Burnaby North, Seymour, and he doesn't support that. What the heck does the NDP represent?
You know what the NDP represents? I've been door knocking with Jagmeet Singh in Burnaby South. I know Burnaby South, Evan. I used to represent it for 25 years. And what I'm hearing on the doorstep with Jagmeet is what we are really excited about is we've got a leader who's actually, he's got our back. He's prepared to fight for us to have housing. He's prepared to fight the Kinder Morgan pipeline.
But you guys don't agree.
He's prepared to fight.
But this is not NDP policy. To be fair, this is LEAP policy. This is LEAP manifesto stuff. Ending, you want to leave all oil and all natural gas, all fossil fuels
Hold
in the ground.
No, no, you're putting words in my mouth.
What are you saying?
I didn't say leave everything in the ground. That's not what I said. I said, no, you quoted it. No new oil and gas infrastructure. And I said, we're probably going to have to leave a lot of the oil and gas in the ground if we're going to meet these targets.
A lot of people would want to know, again, if there's an NDP government, if you get elected and you're part of the government, would you urge an NDP federal government to raise, we're talking about carbon tax and price on carbon, would you say raise it higher to meet the targets, if you want to meet those targets?
Carbon taxes are one element of a strategy, but if we're really serious, the only way that we can meet these targets effectively is if we go way beyond just, you know, carbon taxes. We've got to transform our economy. It's got, maybe you've heard about something called a Green New Deal, right? It's an exciting concept that says we can do things differently. We can build that housing. Jagmeet Singh has talked about 500,000 new housing units. Put those families to work. People say to me, what about Alberta? What about those workers? You don't give a damn about those workers. I've even heard that from some new Democrats. Those workers have children whose planet is in peril. And the last chance we have is the next election to make sure there's enough new Democrats, hopefully led by Jagmeet Singh, to say we put the planet and we put people before corporate profits.
All right. Well, two things. Would it be fair to say that you're in this to radicalize the NDP a bit more? I'm telling you, you sound different than Jagmeet Singh. You take stronger positions, I would say, further to the left, if you want to categorize it. Are you fearlessly now, you're back after a 15-year absence, are you trying to radicalize the NDP?
I am so proud to be part of a party and part of a movement that is led by a leader who's committed to making a profound difference, not just for the people in his constituency, around issues of housing and around issues of access to medicine. By the way, maybe this is radical. I think we should have a national pharmaceutical company, Evan. A national pharmaceutical company, publicly owned.
Are these NDP policies or are these Svend?
It's not yet, and I'm going to work hard to make it a policy.
But do you understand what you're doing? You're on national television. You're floating out policy ideas that you haven't vetted with your leader. Is this a good idea?
I think the people of Canada, and I think a lot of new Democrats, are excited about the possibility.
So why isn't your leader saying it? I mean, you're running for a guy, you want a national pharmaceutical company? He's never said that.
Well, look.
You've got positions on things.
Give this guy a chance. The fact of the matter is,
you've been here 10 minutes. You've said more things than he's been here a year and a half.
Jagmeet Singh is working his butt off in a constituency, and he's doing a fantastic job.
Right.
I've been door-knocking with him, and we need him in Parliament.
Svend Robinson is back. Is he ever? Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. All right. That is Svend Robinson.